Hi guys, it's been quite a few months since I last made a video. Work's taken over really the last 5 or 6 months. Starting to get on top of things now and getting a little bit of spare time back. I was going to do an update video of the tank, and just took the camera in from the workshop and stood there looking at the tank thinking, wow, that torch looks impressive, and the pulsing Zenio is all still and pulsing and looking fantastic. And I thought that, well, that's not right, and realized that this Jebao pump isn't working. Now, it's only about, what is it, it's probably only about five, six months old, and it's been working absolutely fine. The other day I noticed that the pump had stopped, and I assumed that that was because the I'd put some coarse sand in, and I suspected I'd got a piece caught in here and it had just trapped the rotor, but actually it wasn't. I turned this off and turned it back on again. It was working fine, but today it's dead in the water. And you can check, you can see this is all lit up, all the functions seem to work. You'll see three pins on there, and if you've got a meter you can check these yourself. You'll find there's 24 volts from the plug top adapter on one pin, ground the other, and on the other one is a varying voltage depending on the function that you've selected. So if you'd put it on one of the wave features, you can see the voltage pulsing on and off to create the wave. So as you step through the functions and the speeds, you'll see the voltages varying on one of those pins. So this is obviously working fine, and this is not. The three pins on here give no readings whatsoever, apart from one pair when I think the reading was up in the hundreds of k-ohms. Let me see if I can find that again for you. Yeah, so you're talking 200k, which is clearly not right. So looks like the power header's burnt itself out or done something stupid. I was one of the people that bought this from China, from I can't remember what they're called, fish aquarium or fish tank or something like that. I'll look it up. It was through eBay, but you know, if it is under warranty, which it should be, then I'm sure they're going to ask this to be sent back to China and another one sent out. So it means I'm going to be without the power head for probably a month or longer. So I expect I'm just going to have to go out and buy another one. And after this experience, I probably won't buy another of the Jebao's, however you pronounce that. It's a shame. It, you know, it worked really well, but if the reliability is going to be, you know, 5 or 6 months tops, I suspect it's time to get a more reliable brand. So yeah, what I thought we'd do is I'll see if I can crack this open and just see what's going on inside. I think it might be a bit tough without doing any damage to it, but yeah, I thought we'd give it a go. So there'll be a second video to this one later on if I can get this open in any meaningful way that gives something to show you guys. So yeah, back later hopefully, and I'll also do a short video later on just with details of plans, reviews and other things that I've done in the past that need updating. So yeah, thanks for watching. I'll catch you later.